वायुलेखन शास्त्र प्रमाण. टुडे आई विल टेक द वर्स फ्रॉम वैष्णवीय तंत्र एंड वाल्मीकि रामायण अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ लेखन वायुलेखन. These are our shastras, the words of our shastras, not my own words. Both the scriptures, they say, Japat Shatgunam Punyam Ram Naam Prale. Japad means japa. When we do japa, japa means japa is of different types. Vachika, loud means more audible, and Upanishu means murmuring japa. Vachika means Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Upanishu japa means Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And Mansik japa means either the lips are moving, mental japa. This is also maybe a part of between Upanishu and Mansik. Mansik means without the lips moving, also in their mind. Very difficult to pronounce. It is for only advanced sadhakas that one can actually pronounce and actually correctly the mantra in the mind. Because Krishna, Krishna, the tongue touches on the top, it bends. And Hare, Hare, Krishna. And Ramo, Ramo. It is not Ramo or not Ram. It is not Ram or Ramo. It is Ramo, Rama, Rama, Rama. It is not Ram because the Ma is not a halant. You know, there is no halant. Halant means half Ma, like Ram. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. No. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And Krishna is Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Ana, Hastu Nivritti Vachaku, Ana. Ana is, if you make it na, then it don't become a Nivritti Vachaku. Kristubhuvachak Shabd Mahabharat says, Yudhishthir Maharaj, I think. So, Tayoraikyam Parabrahma iti bidhiyate. If you take the correct syllables, then it will become Parabrahma. Kri, it is not Kru, it is not Kri, it is Kri. Krishna, no. Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. This is the correct pronunciation. This is also, you know, why pronunciation is important? Because in Harinam Chintamani, Varna Vyavadhan is described by Haridas Thakur that when it is not pronounced, Spashta Uchcharan Purvak, Sukhakara Naam or Sthira Naam. Three types of names are given. So Sthira means stable, and first is Spashta, means proper pronunciation. Otherwise there will be Varna Vyavadhan. Means Vyavadhan means obstacle, and Varna means in pronunciation, in the sound. So when there are obstacles, the potency of the name is reduced. Already there are 10 offenses. Further, if we don't pronounce it correctly, then it will reduce the potency. कमिंग बैक टू द अवर वायुलेखन प्रमाण शास्त्र प्रमाण जपात शतगुणम पुण्यम. द जप आई एक्सप्लेन आई कैन आई दैट इज वाई लिखित जप लेखन इज ऑल्सो टर्म्ड इन मेनी मेनी ओल्डन टाइम्स फ्रॉम ओल्डन टाइम्स इट्स अ एंशियंट प्रैक्टिस लिखित जप लिख लेखन यू नो गौर सुंदर हिमसेल्फ रोट द नामावली द नेम्स ऑफ द लॉर्ड. सो इट्स अ वेरी एंशियंट प्रैक्टिस एंड when temples were built in the ancient times, then, you know, they used to tell thousands of devotees to write the Namakshara Nama syllables, and then those syllables were actually, those books were actually put in the foundation during the Pran Pratishtha, during before the building of the temple. So, because the foundation is Naam, without Naam, Akshara, who will take your offenses against the deities? It's impossible. Nobody can actually save you from the 64 Seva Aparads. Only the Naam Akshara can. So, Naam Akshara Vigraha should be there in every temple to carved on Shila like Veerchandra Prabhuji, Bhagwan. He gave it to his associate, the Namakshara Shila. Many Gaurkishore Das Babaji used to worship that. So all our Acharyas, even though they may not have described, but everyone like Vishwanath Chakravarti, for example, even he was in Radhakund. He was meditating on how many syllables, every syllable of the Kama Gayatri Mantra stands for one moon on Krishna's form. So he could count 25 syllables and 25 moons. But when he read Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, he said there are 24 and a half moons. So this Kama Gayatri has 24 and a half syllables. So technically he was a big Sanskrit scholar, the greatest of all the Kaviraj, the Rasikas, and Krishnadas Kaviraj also was. So he was thinking and very disturbed. Because he didn't want to commit any offense against Krishnadas Kaviraj, who is Kasturi Manjari, Radharani's intimate servant. So he fasted for many days, and then Radharani appeared, and Radharani told him the name of a shastra where it is described that and V. I cannot tell you the whole Kama Gayatri in public, but ya and V, one word is ya and the other one is V, that both of them combine and form half a syllable, so half moon on Krishna's. So each syllable is representing a moon. So you know it is a science, the Namaksharas. It is not something something new or something invented by me or something. No, I am a Shudra, insignificant Jiva in front of the infinite Namaksharas, Anant Hari, Bhakti Vinod Thakur writes, Chidakshara Akar, Akshara Akar, Chidanandamay Akshara Akar. So Akshara Akar, Akshara, are in Chaitanya Mangal, it is said in the throne of Gauranga also, the Aksharas are imprinted. So, this is a whole science. I can give you so many proofs. And Hari Bhakti Vilas is full of Namakshara. There's proofs how you stamp on your body and then you will become free. You will be with the Lord. So, Namakshara Radharani also told Sakhis, please write Krishna Namakshara on my body. So, So coming back again to our, sorry, there are so many streams of pramana going from one pramana. So I get carried away. Please forgive me for that. Coming back to the pramana from the Vaishnaviya Tantra and Valmiki Ramayana. Japat Shatagunam Punyam. So let me explain again. There needs more explanation. I was explaining Likhita Japa. Likhita Japa is Manasik Japa. So Lekhan is actually Manasik Japa. I'll explain to you how from taking some. First, let me explain Japa. Japat Shatagunam Punyam. And Shata. Shata means 100 times. Punyam means spiritual piety. It is not material piety. The word Punyam. Here we are comparing spiritual practice, like spiritual practices, because Lekhan is also spiritual. It is of the Lord's name, and Japa is also Uchcharan, the pronunciation of the Lord's name. So these are spiritual practices. So here the word Punyam does not mean material Punyam. It means spiritual Punyam, spiritual power, spiritual piety, spiritual potency. Just like somebody may ask, what is your, how can you claim that way? This is only material punyam in this verse. Then my answer is from the Bhagavatam first canto. If you see, Shukadev Goswami says, Shrinavatam Svakatha Krishna Punya Shravana Kirtana Punya Shravana Kirtana. So punya word is used, hearing the anything about the Supreme Personality of God. Shrinavatam Svakatha Krishna punya. Because he's sitting in the heart, he hears what you are hearing. So then he starts cleansing. So that's what Shukadev says. So Shukadev says punya. Again he hears the word punya. He doesn't use spiritual punya or, you know, he just uses punya. So Hridayanta, and that punya will, the Lord starts cleaning. Hridayanta Stoya Bhadrani Vidhu. Vidhunoti Surit Satam, he himself starts cleansing in our heart. So now somebody may say, so now nobody can argue anything, you know, it's Punya. Bhagavatam, which rejects Kaitava Dharma, all kinds of Dhamma, Dharma Projito, Kaitava Dharma, Saranam, Satam, it rejects Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha. In the beginning, still it says Punyam. That Shravana is Punyam. It is Swarup Siddha Bhakti. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Lekhanam, Smaranam, Vandanam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Sakyam. So Atmani Vedanam, these are not, what do you call, secondary Bhakti. These are the primary. They are the very hard. And out of them, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Lekhanam, and Smaranam, these four. So Smaranam is possible by Shravanam, Kirtanam, Lekhanam. You may say, why Lekhan is not mentioned in by Prahlad in the nine kinds of bhakti? The answer is very simple, because actually Lekhana is Smarana. So it doesn't have to be mentioned separately. Because it is like, it is Smarana. Lekhan is, we are just moving our finger in the air in Vayu Lekhan, so that we can remember inside the forms of the Lord. It's a assisting, you know, it's a complementary to Smaranam. It is to make us remember the form of the Lord. So Smaranam includes Lekhanam. If Lekhan is not explicitly mentioned, but as we will see in the series of this, there in Brihannardiya Purana, and Lekhanam is explicitly mentioned along with Shravanam Kirtanam as a process. So it is very bona fide. Please, you know, don't have any doubts. Those who have any doubts, please, I can't tolerate that. It breaks my heart, because Namaksharas are my life and soul. It's life and soul of all our acharyas. I witnessed the power of Namakshar myself, and I have seen those who have offended the Namakshar, what has happened to them. I can't. So going back to the verse. Coming back to the verse from the Vaishnavya Tantra and the Valmiki Ramayana, Japat Sadgunam Punyam Ram Naam Pralekhane, Pralekhane. So second line I will explain later, just like I said, Japat. Let me explain the word Japat and Shata from Hari Bhakti Vilas. Hari Bhakti Vilas, in 17.159, it states by Yajnavalkya Smriti, from the Yajnavalkya Smriti, that Upanshu Japa Yuktasya Tasmat Chataguno Bhavet Sahastro Manasah Prokto Yasmat Dhyana Samo. He saw, very, very important, very important verse. Hari Bhakti Vilas is a manual for understanding what is Naam in its different aspects, like Shabda, Akshara, Manasika, Upanshu, Vachika. Without reading the 17th chapter of Hari Bhakti, we cannot understand. So, it means Upanshu Japa Yuktasya Tasmat Chataguna Bhavet. So, it says that Upanshu Japa Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, takes us more internal, you know. When you say Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, it benefits others. When we are morose and there are so many desires in our harmful desires, then loud chanting helps to calm them. But if the mind is peaceful, then when we do Upanishad, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, then it is Hare Hare, then it helps. It was more internal than Vachika. That's why Yajnavalkya Smriti and Hari Bhakti Vilas 17.59, it states that Upanshu Japa Yuktasya Tasma Shata Gunova. Chata Gunova. Again, the Shata word is 100 times. Upanshu Japa is 100 times Vachika Japa. Hare Krishna. And when you go inside, into the mind, the japa, which is very difficult, I don't recommend it, please, because it's, you know, some devotees say they chant Mansik Japa and they lack of names. My Dandut pranams to them, I will not judge anyone. But it's very difficult to pronounce mentally, unless your naam, roop, guna, lila is manifesting in the name. Even Haridas Thakur used to chant Vachika, Manasika, Upanshu and Mansika, 1 lakh each, you know, 100,000 each. So it's not possible. And then at the end he said to Gauranga, I cannot do it, I cannot complete my vow. So please don't, just go in because of the numbers, but try to understand the remembrance is very important. Whatever is giving you a lot of remembrance, I have written an article on that. Upanshu, for the normal chanters of Harinam, Upanshu Japa is the best. If their mind is not very rumbling and very agitated, then this Vachika is best. Kirtan is an extension of Vachika Japa. Like Kirtan is Sarvendriya Spurti. That's why Haridas Thakur says Kirtan has a lot of potency. Kirtan comes in a different category, you know. So, it's a singing. It's like a... So, Sahasro Manasah Prokto Yasma Dhyana Samohisah. As Upanshu is 100 times more powerful than Vachika, loud chanting, Manasika Japa is 1,000 times more powerful than Vachika. So, you see, Upanshu is a big jump, like 100 times, and Manasika is a little more jumped, only 10 times more than Upanshu. That's why Upanshu is the most recommended for Harinam Japa. Because Mansika is very difficult, like I said, for unless we have years and years and years of practice of chanting lakhs and lakhs of names, pronouncing them clearly. But it is Dhyana Samohi Saha. It is like meditation. The word dhyana samo hi saha is very, very important. In this original verse from Haribhakti Vilas 17.159, which is quoted from Yajnavalkya Smriti, Smriti again is remembrance. So, Smriti Shastras. So, yasma dhyana sama. It is a topmost form of meditation. It's equal to meditation, dhyana. The mental remembrance. So, somebody may say, okay, this is Yajnavalkya's words and it is in Haribhakti Vilas 17.159. It's not important. Our six Goswamis never said that or something. Some argument could be made. And the answer to that is given. So, Sanatan Goswami makes it clear in his Digdarshini Tika. He says, Upanshu japa yuktasya japa shata gunasya vachikad japa shata guno bhavet iti artha. So he clarifies here. He says, Upanshu japa yuktasya japa shata gunasya vachikad japat. So Upanshu japa yuktasya tasmat shata guno bhavet. So here the word vachika is not used in this verse. It is a tasmat. So what Sanatana Goswami is explaining in this verse is that tasmat actually means vachika. So it's very beautiful, very, very, very merciful of him that he has clarified this. And Upanshu japa, it means that so he is actually agreeing with it. He is actually confirming it, establishing it, that actually Upanishad is 100 times and Mansika is 1,000 times Vachika Japa. So now it is Dhyana Samohi Saha. So now let's the mental Japa. So what to do for those people who cannot do mental Japa? Very difficult to pronounce inside. Very difficult. Because the mind is so full of all kinds of impressions from millions and zillions of births, and unless I have seen devotees, with all due respect to everyone, many devotees or some devotees, they can't even pronounce the Maha Mantra properly. Of course, they say the mood is important, the bhav, it's very good, but if the bhav is there, if the mood is to please the Lord is there, then one should. Then one will find out how can I pronounce also correctly for the pleasure of the Lord. So if they are watching, please try to pronounce. I am not, don't think someone is higher, somebody is lower. I just want everybody to help in my own insignificant way to pronounce correctly, to approach the name. So, we come back to this manasa. So manasa japa is dhyana samuhi sa sahastra manasa prakto. Sahastro means 1,000 times more than vachika. So what to do when we can't do manasa japa? This is where likhit japa comes. Lekhan. Vayu lekhan comes. And you will say, okay, how to connect? How do you say that likhita japa is manasa? That is explained. Again, let me discuss Harinam Chintamani's 17th chapter, 158 verse. It is very clear. It says, Dhiya yadakshara akshrenya. Wah. This akshara word is used. Please remember here. Very important. Dhyayad akshara shrenya varnat varnam padat padam shabdartha chintana abhyasa shabdartha chintana abhyasa sayukto manaso japaha. This is the definition of manasa japa. So that is why Likhita Japa is called by many seers, many saints, many acharyas as Manasa Japa. Because of this verse from Harinam Chintamani. And there's Sanatana Goswami also gives a tika. So it is bona fide. Please understand. धिया यद अक्षरक्षरेणी. लेट्स गेट बैक टू द वर्स. हरि भक्ति विलास 17.158 एंड दिस इज इन द प्रोसेस आई एम डिस्कसिंग द वर्स फ्रॉम वैष्णवीय तंत्र द प्रमाण फॉर लेखन फ्रॉम वैष्णवीय तंत्र एंड वाल्मीकि रामायण जप जपार्षद गुणम पुण्यम राम नाम प्रलेखने. सो आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ जपा हियर एंड वॉट different levels of japa are and what is manasa japa. We have come to that point of how manasa japa is vayulekhan, how vayulekhan is manasa japa, which is 1000 more times more powerful than vachika japa. So we come to this point here. Dhyad yad aksharakshrenya, very important, very very important. First, this is the dhyad yad aksh. You have to capture the syllables in your heart. Dhiya yad aksharakshrenya. Varnat varnam padat padam. Varna an akshara. Padat padam. At every part of the name akshara. And the syllables and the sound shabdartha, the meaning artha means the meaning. So the meaning of the syllables aksharakshrenya dhya means heart, varnat every meaning of padat padam. Why in vayulekhan we actually visualize every single stroke out of the 10 strokes of Nitai Naam for Harinam Ruchi? Because of this verse from Harinam Hari Bhakti Vilas 17.158. Varnat Varnam Padat Padam. Every single syllable, every single part of the Aksharakshrenya, Dhyadhya Aksharakshrenya, and the sound also. And then when we meditate mentally on the form and the shape of every syllable, then shabdartha, the sound, the meaning of the sound also automatically remembrance comes. And every single practitioner of vayulekhan has found this in their practice, that actually vayulekhan enhances so much ruchi in harinam, japa, kirtan, shravan krishna, even krishna katha Shravana, Srimad Bhagavatam's hearing, you know, in Dham Vas or in Sadhu Sangha, Archa Vigra Seva, whatever you are doing, you know, you are explaining to others, it increases your ruchi, because this is the process. Dhyadhya Daksharakshrenya Varnat Varnam Padat Padam Shabdartha Chintanabhyasa. Chintana Abhyasa. Abhyasa means again the practice comes. So that is why I have made those pictures, the paintings of Nitai and I have given Nitai Ni Sambandhata Abhideya and E Prayojan. So and the basic outlines of Nitai's form and his syllables and his pastimes related to those syllables. Of course, pastimes are a little higher stage qualities than pastimes. Like I said, we should go step by step, you know. Don't think, oh, now I can see the forms, then I'll just directly think of the pastime. No, let the form become more clearer. Let the form reveal the qualities. Let you get the fragrance, this voice, movements. Some devotees have experienced movements in the forms. So it's good. It's a sign of progress in Dhyadhya Aksharakshrenya, visualizing the Naam Aksharas. Shabdartha Chintanabhyasa. Chintan means remembrance, smaran. Chintan. My Gurudev also says, Naam Bhaja Naam Chintan Naam Karasar. My Gurudev gave this instruction, but I am realizing the truth more and more every day to realize this instruction. Shabdartha शब्दार्थ चिंतनाभ्यास वर्णात अक्षर श्रेणी चिंतनाभ्यास प्रैक्टिस. सम डिवोटी से वाई आर यू गिविंग वाई लेखन विद द फॉर्म्स एंड व्हाट इज द नीड. अभ्यास हरिभक्ति विलास इज प्रैक्टिस इज रिक्वायर्ड इन परफेक्टिंग द रूप स्मरण इन द नाम. वी आर नॉट डूइंग इट इंडिपेंडेंटली ऑफ नाम. It's not like we are just rejecting the Naam and just thinking of the form of the Lord walking. That also is good, but we are actually the Akshara Akshraniya. We are actually combining it with the name syllables, Nitai Naam Aksharas, which are the most merciful. They don't have any offense consideration. And also with the Shabda of the Hari Naam. So here we are chanting Japa only of Hari Naam. We are not chanting Japa of Nitai Naam, or we are not replacing Harinam by any other mantra or any other thing. Panchatattva mantra is also there. We chant Panchatattva mantra, most merciful Panchatattva, to get their mercy. So we are not replacing Harinam. Harinam is Shabda and Nitai Naam is Akshara. For us, we are worshipping both the Parabrahmas of Naam. So, and one Akshara helps in the Shabda, according to this Harinam Chintamani verse. Sa yukto manaso japaha. Sa yukto manaso japaha. Then that is called as Manasik Japa. Manasik Japa. Which we have said heard that in other verse of Hari Bhakti Vilas, which is 1,000 sahastro, is 1,000 times more powerful than Vachika Japa and 10 times more powerful than Upanishu. So if we, even if we're doing Harinam Japa, Upanishu, still Vayulekhan is technically, according to this, it is 10 times more powerful because it's Manasika. So that is why we are not replacing Harinam, but it is assisting Harinam because it is 10 times more powerful according to these verses. Literally, I'll explain the original Praman verse. So Manaso Japaha. Let me come back to the Digdarshini Tika. Which may get missed otherwise, of Sanatan Goswami. He says, Varnat ekasmat kramenanya varnam vyapya. Means ekasmat, one-pointedly, krama means the sequence. See, so in Vayulekhan we have the sequence of the varnam vyapya. Wow, I mean, this is the pearl-like words of Sanatan, Srila Sanatan Goswami. It exactly describes the, it's so secret in the scriptures, Nitai Vayulekhan, this process is so secret. I'm sorry for taking so many years to actually analyze this verse. And those who will listen to this video, they are the most fortunate. They will get the mercy of Srila Sanatan Goswami's secret. Varnam vyapya, all pervading in the syllables of the mantra, the meanings are all pervading. Evam padat padam vyapya, then it is pervading in every single part of the aksharas. Itham shabdasya arthasya chayat chintanam anusandhanam. Again, the word anusandhanam comes, you know. I'm always saying in Harinam Chintamani also, he said, when you chant japa, look at the form, and if you cannot see and try to search out the form of Shamsundar, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare, Anusandhanam, do Anusandhan, Anusandhan, Sandhan means to search out, seek out, find out, Tasya Abhyasa, and the practice, Chintanam, the practice of remembering via searching for it and visualizing it, you know. You can call it even imagining it, but you should seek out, because imagination is not based on your speculation, it's based on the Shastra. So it is visualization. And Abhyasa Punar Punar Avritti, again and again and again one should do it. That is very important. The original verse, the Pramana, which we have violated in Shastra Pramana, is Japat Shatagunam Punyam Ramanam Pralekhani from Valmiki Ramayana and Vaishnaviya Tantra. So in that I am explaining from Hari Bhakti Vilas, illuminating this verse with Sanatan Goswami's commentaries and Hari Bhakti Vilas, which Sanatan Goswami says, Abhyasa Punar Punar Avritti. So when we write in the air again and again and again, we are actually imprinting our mind with the varna, the ekasmad, one pointedly, with every single stroke, with every single meaning of every syllable, every stroke, and the shabda arthas, chintanam, anusandhanam. We are searching for the form in each syllable. And we are practicing it again and again. We are actually following the instructions of Srila Sanatan Goswami. I am very proud to say that we are pleasing him so much. So, before I go back to the original verse, so Shata we saw here, Upanshu is 100 times more than powerful than Vachika, and Mansika is 1000 more powerful. So Mansika is 10 times technically more powerful than Upanshu. So that is why the original verse, Japato, there's another verse by Haridas Thakur, okay? There's so much, 100 and 1000 calculations here. So, this is the first video in my life. I'm presenting everything in one video. So, this is going to be my best video of my life. You know, it is turning out to be. So, Haridas Thakur said, Japato Hari Namani Sthane Shatagunadika Atmani Unatyuchair Japan Shrotrin Punatihi. So, considering the benefit given to others, japa, he is comparing, japa is, others, benefit, it is about benefit giving to others. This Hari Bhakti Vilas is saying benefit for us. Upanshu is, Japa is 100 times more powerful for us, and Mansika is 1000 times more than Vachika. But with respect to Japan, so the Punati, purifying others, what is there? Even more than Upanshu is meant for our own deliverance. So when we do Kirtan or when we do loud chanting, then this is another twist. But one has to understand there is no contradiction between what Haridas Thakur says and what Sanatan Goswami says. Otherwise, one will make Vaishnava Prad. And what Hari Bhakti Vilas says, Haridas Thakur is saying with respect to benefit offered to others, that he is saying that Japan Shrotrin Punatihi, that Atmanya Punati, Japan Sthane Shata Gunadika, again Shata, 100 times more. So loud Kirtan is 100 times more powerful than Upanishu Japa with respect to benefit of others. Okay. So now there are three different blocks here. Let us analyze. Vaishnaviya Tatra Valmiki Ramayana says that Lekhan is 100 times more powerful than Japa. Hari Bhakti Vilas says that Japa is more 1000 times more powerful than Vachika. Upanishu is 100 times more powerful than Vachika. And Haridas Thakur says that Kirtan or Vachika is 100 times more powerful than Upanishu for giving benefit to others. So here you see in the three different Shastric injunctions, still the 1000, the Manasik part remains the highest. Sahastro Manaso Prakto. So the Lekhan, and through Vayu Lekhan, we are giving benefit to others through the Vayu, the air. That's why Chaitanya Bhagavat says, Iha Vata Asa Lagi Beka Jare Gai, Krishna Tara Nahi Chhadi Be Sarva Thai. So how do we understand these three in connection with each other? Actually, they are not, they are mutually complementary, they are not contradicting. So if you consider Lekhan as Manasika, Japa, then the first verse actually is kind of confirming what Hari Bhakti Vilas says, that from the Valmiki Ramayana and the Vaishnava Tantra, that Ramanama Pralekhane. Japachat Gunam Punyam Ramanam Pralekhane. So Lekhan has 100 times more powerful than Japa. So now here, actually technically speaking, I will just give you the stats. I will not make such a claim. But it says, Ramanam Pralekhane. I will explain what is Pralekhan. That is another topic in the same video. But Lekhana, Pralekhana, Lekhana is 100 times more powerful than Japa. And this Japa is obviously Upanishad Japa. Japa to Hari Namani. Or any kind of Japa, technically. So, and mostly the most common is Upanishad Japa. So technically, if you see, because it is a man on the level of manasa, viswasha, varnat varnam, padat padam, akshara akshrenya, from the Hari Bhakti Vilas, so it is on the level of manasika. And lot of saints already accepted, lot of acharyas, that lekhana is manasik japa, likhita japa is manasik japa, because the akshara are non-different from the sound of the naam. So here it is said that it is 100 times more than Upanishu. You can consider it Vachika, but when it says Japa, it means normally both, you know. I mean, it's a generic term. So if you consider that, then it becomes, it, if you consolidate both this Vaishnavya Tantra and Valmiki Ramayana and Hari Bhakti Vilas, if you consolidate both, you will see first is Vachika, then Upanishu is 100 times more powerful than Vachika. Japa, we are going Japa first, then Manasika Japa is 10 times more powerful than Upanishu, and Likhita Japa, Lekhana, Pralekhana, Lekhana is 100 times more powerful than Upanishu. So it goes like Vachika into 100 is Upanishu, Vachika into 1000 is Manasik Japa, and Vachika into 10,000 is Lekhana. I'm literally, as it is, presenting the verses, you know. I'm not adding anything, subtracting any zeros or adding any zeros. So please don't, you know, whatever questions you have, you take it to Sanatan Goswami and Yajnavalkya Smriti and Valmiki Ramayana and Vaishnavya Tantra, where all these verses are mentioned. And so this is the 10,000 times technically from Vachika. Lekhan is 10,000 times more powerful than Japa. So does that mean that we give up Japa? No, not at all. Japa is our bread and butter. Japa Shabda. You know, what is the use of focusing on Nam Akshara if you don't relish the Nam Shabda, the sound of the name after Vayulekhan? You know, Nithai Vayulekhan you do. My favorite pastime, I cannot talk about pastime, I'm fallen soul, but my favorite hobby, you can say, is that after Vayulekhan, I love to sing Kirtan, I love to read, I love to hear sound, as you know, listen to sound. So that is very, very important. This is the hierarchy which we say from this word Japato. Japachat Gunam Punyam Ramanam Pralekhane and Sahastro. Sahastro manasa prokto yasma dhyana samohisa. So, we are almost coming to the end of this inspired. I mean, the Namaksharas are. I am just a rock puppet, but the Namaksharas are inspiring such a detailed elucidation of their glories. We saw the different levels, and ultimately, and what about the verse that Sane Shat Gunadika about Kirtan or about loud singing? That is for other souls. So that is also 100 times more than Japa. So also that also falls in the category of somewhere around Manasa, Japa. And Lekhan. So Kirtan and Lekhan are the most powerful. Lekhan and Kirtan, according to the third proof from Haridas Thakur. So because it benefits others. So and because of the verse from Chaitanya Bhagavat, Ihan Vatas Lagi Bek Jaragai Tahare O Krishna Na Chadi Be Sarvathai. So that verse, that the air of Nitai is very important. The Nitai and Nitai's Nam syllables are the same. So the Nam sound, you cannot feel the air. You know, Nam sound is produced. It goes away from us. Whereas Vayulekhan is the Nam Akshara. So the sound enters into our ears, and okay, in the form of the Nam sound also the Lord is there, and the Nam Akshara also, the Lord is there. When we touch Him in the air. So through the medium of the air, Sparshena Dehatmi Twacham, Bhagavatam says the Sparsha or the Tacha is the medium. Air, Adhyatmani means air. Air is the medium of Sparsha, of touch. So we are actually following as it is. All the scriptures, and when we are touching through Vayulekhan, then we are also giving an element of the air which is nitized with the touch of Nitai Namakshar. You cannot say that all the molecules come to me, only the nitized molecules of air. The air goes in all directions when we write in the air. So that air, if it touches someone, then Krishna will never leave that person, according to Chaitanya Bhagavat, as it is literally. If you accept the words of Srila Vrindavan Das Thakur, who is none other than Ved Vyas himself in Kali Yuga and great associate of the last disciple of Nitai Chand. Tahare ko Krishna chadi be sarvatai. So then again the Lekhan, Vayulekhan comes in with Sthane Shata Gunadika of Haridas, the third proof. So just like Kirtan, you are singing loudly, so you are benefiting others. Others are able to hear the sound. Similarly, in Vayulekhan, you are writing in the air, and the air is touching others, so you are benefiting them also. So both Kirtan and Vayulekhan are, that is why it is Vayulekhan. So that is why this verse, we coming back to the verse, Japat Shat Gunam Punyam. As I explained, Punyam is not material Punya, because Bhagavatam also is Srinvatam Swakatha, Punya Shravana Kirtan, hearing and singing Kirtan about the Lord is also Punya. So this is talking about spiritual power, piety, potency. Ram Naam Pralekhane. Now you may say it is, this verse is only about Ram Naam. It is not about Nitai Naam or Krishna Naam or Radha Naam. You may say that question. So that question I will try to answer now as follows. राम नाम प्रलेखने, राम नाम It is Rama. First of all, Rama, according to our Acharyas, have given a Rasika meaning of Nam also, which is Radha Ramana. Rama. Ra comes from Radha and Ma comes from Ramana, second Ma. Ra Ma. Mana. So Radha Ramana. So Rama iti Satyananda Chidatmani iti Rama Padena Super Brahma Vidhiyate. So Ram is Parabrahma. Ram can be Radharaman, he can be Balaram, he can be Nitai Ram, he can be Ram, Sita Ram, or if you want to see the Shaktyavesha avatars in this world, he can be Parashuram. You know, it depends, you know, whoever you want to remember. But basically, our Gaudiyas, we remember the highest understanding of Radharamana or Nitai Ram, because Nitai is also in Madhurya as Anangamanjari, which even Balaram's ontological position has been raised in Nitai Gaur Leela, and he has become Gorochan in color just like Anangamanjari, golden, and his consorts are also Anangamanjari, Janva and Vasudha. So Ram can have many meanings, you know. So Ram Naam Pralekhane. So Ram Naam, again, you know, it is 100 times more powerful, spiritually powerful than Japa. So Ram Naam Pralekhane. Pralekhane. Ram Naam. So Ram, you cannot say just it is your, you know, normal Ram, Sita Ram only because it's in Valmiki Ramayana. No, Ram is valid. And plus my reply to this is, if this verse is valid to Ram Naam, even if you take Ram as Sita Ram, but still Ayodhya is just an expansion of Braja and Navadvip and Ekachakra. So if it is valid for Sita Ram, it has been valid for millions of times more to Nitai Ram. Because Nitai Ram is the source of everything, you know, from him everything is coming. Everything. He's the, you know, Sakala Sambhavatante Jate Avatari. He is Avatari, just like Gaur Krishna, his brother. He's not just an avatar. So anything is possible, everything is coming from him. Krishnadas Kaviraj describes in Chaitanya Charitamrita, everything is coming from him, even the Mool Sankarshan, Chaturvyuha, primary in Dwarka, and then Narayan, the Dvitiya Chaturvyuha, the Vaikuntha planets, the Karanodakshai, the Brahma Jyoti, the Garbhodakshai, Shirodakshai, the unlimited universes, the Super Soul, the Ananta Shesha, everything, every spirit soul and everything animate, everything is coming from Nitai Ram. So Ram Naam. So if it is valid for Sita Ram, how much it is valid for Nitai's name, Nitai Ram's name. Ram Naam Pralekhane. And finally, we come to the last word of this verse, is Pralekhane. Pralekhane means Pralekhane. Pralekhana means, you know, writing. And you can write on paper. I have written an article why we don't write with a pen on paper, because there are so many meanings. I have given more than 20 reasons, because nowadays we don't have bhojapatra, we have to cut trees, and we don't have natural inks, we have all artificial inks, and the pens are also, which it hurt the body of the Lord. At that time, if you use the original substrates for writing, it's okay. And plus the direct touch, we touch the pen and the pen touches the Namakshar. And Vayu is the medium of touch according to Srimad Bhagavatam. And Nitai's Vayu has specific benefits, like giving Krishna becomes, never leaves that person. So why not? The Vayu is the highest medium substrate for writing. So Pralekhane means you write in the highest way. And also it means Pralekhane means you write with remembrance. What Hari Bhakti Vilas says, you know, is very clear. Dhyayat aksharakshrenya shabdartha chintana abhyasa sayukto manaso japa varanat varanam chintanam anusandhanam tasya abhyasa puna puna avrutti. That is the meaning of Pra. Pra means again and again, remember the form. Pra, remember, it's pro, you know, we have plus or pro. Remember the form while writing.